Well, that's quite enough of that. I'm sure you'll enjoy seeing the rest of that video later on. But in the meantime, what you really want to know is how to win, what separates winners from losers. And that's what I'm going to teach you in this free video. The main thing is mindset. The mindset of a winner over the mindset of a competitor. A lot of people will just say, let's go and compete at this event or that event. Let's train all winter and see how we do next year. But this isn't good enough. If you listened to the interviews of the people who failed to win at the Olympics, you'll hear them saying things like, I dreamt all year about making this final. Well, okay, so they made the final, but they didn't win the final because that wasn't their objective. Winning wasn't one of their goals. This is the difference. You have to set out to win. We're not all going to be Olympic champions, but we can win lots of things, finding our standard and work our way up. And maybe we can win at a world level. Most of us have no idea what we're capable of. You probably have no idea, but set your goals. Set a goal that you feel are achievable. They might be goals for today, this training session, or it might be a goal for this week, or this month, or this season. Thinking further ahead, you might be looking at this year or this Olympiad, a four-year cycle. But you need to set those goals and you need to write them down. And don't be inhibited by what other people say. People will very often try and put you down and put down any ambition that you might have. Even people very close to you will poo-poo ideas of great ambitions. So it's often best to keep these things to yourself. Keep your list of objectives, your goals, to yourself. Don't go telling everybody that you're going to win the Olympics, because they'll just say, oh, don't be silly. You might be perfectly capable of winning the Olympics, but they'll put you down and put doubt in your mind. This year I had to put a friend of mine aside, that's to say I had to avoid seeing him, because he was too negative. He was saying things that I didn't want to hear. I didn't want to hear him saying that what I'd set out as my target was impossible. And he was saying that sort of thing. And I had to shun him, because I really needed people around me who were going to say, you can do it, Steve. Or things like, good luck, not that you'll need it. Those sort of people secretly give you confidence in your ability. So who you have around you and what you tell them, you have to be careful of. So looking at your goals, you can't put them down in a negative way. Like I've just said, can't, that's a bad way of phrasing a goal. If you say, I don't want to be last all the time anymore, that's a negative goal. And better phrasing your goal in a positive way, so that it's, I want to be first all the time. Much better. And then you can implant that image in your mind, in your subconscious, of what it is you want to do, rather than something you want to avoid. If you're always putting the image in your mind of something that you want to avoid, then you keep replaying that image of what you're trying to avoid. What's that going to do? It's going to reinforce the image of the thing that you're trying to avoid. That's not a good thing to be carrying around in your head. Your mindset needs to be a positive one. I first discovered this business of goal setting about 1987 in this book, The Lazy Man's Way to Riches. I lent it to my sister and her dog got it. As you can see, it's a bit dog-eaten at the moment, but I rediscovered it recently when she moved house, and I'm very pleased that I haven't lost the book, because it has some very useful advice about goal setting. It's about business really, but it's helpful to athletes as well. Just write down your goals and then look at them afterwards. And if you see the word no or not, then rephrase your goal. Write it down again. And write down as many things as you like. I mean, you can put in goals about your lifestyle, where you want to live, what sort of car you want to drive. It can be being happy. Anything. Put it down as a goal. In fact, being happy should be one of your goals. And enjoying your sport as you go along should be one of your goals. Because we spend an awful lot more time actually training for our sports, most of us anyway, than we do competing. So it's a good idea to enjoy your sport as you go along. You've written your goals out. There might be quite a long list. You maybe need to prioritise them after that. Is this important to you? Why is it important to you? What would be the consequences if you didn't achieve this? These are the sort of questions that you need to ask yourself. And having put it into a positive way, there's another thing that you need to do with your goals in your description of them, and that is to bring them into the present tense so that you're actually imagining what it's like to have achieved that. So instead of saying, "I want to be Olympic champion," you say, "I am Olympic champion." Instead of saying, "I want to set a personal best on July the 31st, you say, "I set my personal best on July 31st. So you can be quite specific about your goals and put a lot of detail into them, but it is important that you write them down. I can't stress that enough. Writing your goals down is very important. And the next thing is to say them to yourself each day, before you go to bed, so that it's in your mind when you go to sleep, and each morning when you get up, so that it's in your mind all day. So you know where you're going. You might have different objectives for a day than you have for a week or a season, but without clarity on where you're going, you will be much less likely to achieve anything. So having developed your outcome and worked on all the details, you will have a lot of words written down, hopefully. And now you need to pare them down. This is where you start to get clever with the psychology. You need to pare them down, reduce essays into paragraphs, reduce paragraphs into sentences, and reduce sentences into power words. And this is what you do. You need to get yourself into a semi-conscious state, so restful. Let's imagine that you can define your state of arousal and scale it from 0 to 10, where 0 is dead and 10 is the fire alarm's just gone off and it's a real fire. Somewhere around 3 is where you want to be. You're not asleep, but you're not wide awake either. And you're in a subdued state of consciousness. And you can bring yourself down to that by monitoring your heart rate. Or if you go to yoga and do the shavasana, the resting at the end of a yoga session, you'll find that your yoga teacher will quite often use a variety of techniques to bring down your level of consciousness so that this is the state that you want to be in. And you use these power words that you've developed and implant them in your head. Just think of maybe one. And then when you bring yourself back to consciousness, that all of that summary that you've done, that's all condensed into that one power word that you can use to help you achieve the correct mindset. Going back to these Olympians, if you listen to the interviews of the people who'd won, well, they've been thinking about it since they were 8 years old in a lot of cases. You hear that time and again. I've been dreaming about this moment all my life. I have pictures on the wall of Muhammad Ali or Steve Redgrave or, you know, their idol, somebody whom they idolize and they wanted to be like. This is what you need to become a winner. That's the first thing. That's what you must do now. Write down your goals, turn them into positive goals, bring them into the present tense, develop your outcome, develop your power words, and practice getting yourself into a subdued state so that you can use the power words. Then you can start to think about how you're going to achieve these goals. So that's the next part of the process, is to think, how can I do that? Write down how you think you might achieve these goals, and then forget about it. Because what is amazing is your brain's subconscious part is much, much more powerful than your conscious brain. And if you've defined the problem, the issue, the objective, and then you forget about it, the subconscious will work out a way of achieving it. But you have to define it quite clearly first. And you need to have a thorough understanding of what is required in order to achieve your goals. So we'll move on in the next video to talk about physiology, training, how the body works, and the sort of things that people do who are successful, and why I've been successful doing the opposite of what a lot of people do. So if you found that helpful and you'd like to know more about how to win, then what I'd like you to do next is to enter your email address below, and I'll send you the next free training video, and you'll see a little bit more of that video I've been preparing and where I'm going with it.